Hello everyone and welcome to this first video where we will be exploring the use of OSL nodes into StudioMax. The main goal of this video and the next couple of videos actually is to help you to make the transition from a 3ds Max legacy workflow to a OSL workflow. And the reason why I'm doing these videos is also because I have a lot of requests and people asking me that they want to work with OSL and they are curious about it, but they don't know necessarily which nodes to use. So as an example, if you want to bring a bitmap or texture into StudioMax, which node should I be using? Or if I want to do color correction, you know, which node should I be using? How can I replace my workflow using OSL nodes? So hopefully this video and the next couple of videos, I'm going to help you to make that transition. Obviously, I'm not going to cover every single node available. I'm just going to focus our attention more on the process of creating materials, on the process of doing look development, and even using OSL nodes when you're doing lighting. It's actually something quite interesting. So let's start with one of the most basic things that you have to do when you're working in any 3D package, which is bringing bitmaps or textures into StudioMax. The best tools that you have available are these two nodes. You can find them if you go to Maps, OSL, and you scroll down after Values. You have this list of OSL nodes, and you have this second option here called Bitmap Lookup. And then if you go a little bit down, you have the Uber Bitmap. And these are the two main nodes that you have to bring textures into StudioMax. Obviously, there are other options for you to bring textures. So for example, if you want to bring an AGI map, what is the best thing you can do? If you scroll up a little bit to this section here called Environment, you have this option called AGI Environment and AGI Lights. As you can see, there are different ways to bring textures. But to create materials, definitely these two are the best ones. Now, the question that you may be asking is, why do we have two ways to bring textures? And that is actually a good question. So if I start with the most basic one, the OSL bitmap lookup, it's quite basic because the only things that you can do is, first of all, select the bitmap or the texture that you want to load. You can also load UDIMs if you are working with UDIMs. And I have an example here of in this node in action. So I have this one, which is loading UDIMs. It's quite simple. All you have to do is click this button here, load UDIM, go to your folder, select the first one, and then automatically the OSL node is going to recognize what's the next UDIMs or the list of UDIMs or UV tilings they're working with. So it's quite practical, in particular if the render you're using doesn't support at this stage the use of UDIMs. Now if I go back to my OSL bitmap lookup nodes, you see the next thing, which I think it's quite practical in my point of view, is that you can change the camera inside StudioMax. Because remember, if you're working with the bitmap and if you need to change the camera for your roughness map, for your normal map, from 2.2 to 1.0, you need to reload the texture, change the value. Now with OSL, you can do that in this interface. And if you are working with Arnold, one thing I have to tell you is if you are using OSL, and if you're working with the base color, don't forget to change the camera to 2.2, because automatically the OSL node is going to set the camera to 1.0. Another thing that you don't see here is any filtering. There is no blur applied to your texture. And this is something that I actually appreciate, because with the bitmap, I would have to manually to remove any blur, because I don't want to apply any blur, any filtering to my textures. I want them to be as sharp as possible. So not having that option here, the fact there is no filtering being applied, it's at least from my workflow, is quite beneficial. And then if you go to position and scale, it does sound quite simple. The only thing you have is the options to change the scale. Now you may be asking, well, this is not something really practical, because with the bitmap nodes in StudioMax, I can change the rotation, I can do tiling, I can do offset. How can I do that with this just simple bitmap? And why should be using an OSL bitmap lookup if I don't have those options? So I think this is a good opportunity to introduce you the concept of, in the OSL workflow, connecting nodes to each other. And connecting those nodes will introduce you a lot of flexibility. I believe it will help you quite a lot when you're creating materials, for example. It does sound quite the opposite of simplicity. It sounds that the workflow is way more complex, because if you have to connect multiple nodes to get what you have with one node, why should you be using this OSL node? Well, let me show you a good example by working with this material. So if I start by connecting my color to my base color, if I connect my roughness to my specular roughness, and if I connect my normal map to my normal map, well, I'm not going to have the most beautiful material, but definitely there is something here. And I think this really exemplifies what I want to show you. Let's say if I want to do an offset, or if I want to do some tiling, or if I want to change, for example, the UV map channel, how can you do that? Well, like I said, you can connect nodes, and if you see in your OSL tab, you have one section here called UVW coordinates. So this here gives you access to a lot of those tools that you need to control your textures. I think the most used ones are the ones you can see in my screen. So the first one, which is definitely the one you're going to use most of the times, it's the UVW transform, the last one. This one here is the one that gives you the opportunity to change the scale, the tiling, the offsets. Even if you want to work with real world scale, you can do that. And you can work with rotation as well. So how does it work? Well, you just simply connect the nodes to the UVW coordinate. Then you also have this one here, which is the UVW channel. So if I want to work with a different map channel, I can change this here. And then this one, I think it's useful in some situations, allows you to change the coordinate space. So you may want to work instead of object, you may want to work with camera or with screen, and you have the opportunity to do that using this node. Why is this way to work much better? Well, because like what you're seeing here, a situation where you can start introducing issues without realizing, because let's say you change the tiling for all the textures, but you completely forgot to do the same thing for roughness. So you may realize that something is wrong with the material, but not necessarily know what. You may spend a couple of minutes trying to figure out what is wrong until you realize, oh, I completely forgot to change the tiling, for example, on my roughness. So why is OSL a little bit more flexible? Well, because with one single nodes, I can change the UV coordinates for all the three maps. And I think now you're starting to see the power of using the OSL nodes, and in particular, why the OSL bitmap lookup, although simple, is actually quite practical. Because using one map, I can control my entire material. And the same thing applies, like, let's say if I want to change the UV mapping channel, well, in a situation of using the bitmap from StudioMax, you'll have to go one by one and change that manually. But if I want to change in one go all the three textures, all I have to do is select the UVW channel, change to the map channel that you want, and connect to your input UVW. That's it. You change the UV mapping. This example, although simple, it really shows you the potential of working with OSL nodes. The fact that you can change the material in one go just using one node, controlling all these textures. Now, this is the most simple option that you have, the OSL bitmap lookup, but then you have the Uber bitmap. So what's the difference? Well, the difference of the Uber bitmap is that all the things that we talked here are introduced in just one single node. And now you may be thinking, well, so why the trouble of doing something like this if you already have one node with everything? Well, it's precisely the same thing happens with the bitmap. I don't have a way to automatically control, using one node to control all of this. I mean, I could connect nodes to the scale, tiling, offset, but then I'll end up with a very complex shading network with no reason at all. The OSL Uber bitmap is precisely the map that you need to use if you're just using one off. So let's say, for example, I'm using this map, and this map I'm using to add to my specular roughness. I don't need to change the tiling. I don't need that the tiling for the base color, roughness, normal map be applied to the dirt map. So the best option you have is basically using the Uber bitmap. This will give you access to everything that you need in a more simplified way. So hopefully, I think this will help you to understand when to use the Uber bitmap and when to use the OSL bitmap. Now, another thing maybe I could cover is the use of the OSL bitmap random tiling. And I'm not going to explore too much all the settings they have available, but definitely what I want to share is the fact that you can use these OSL nodes to remove tiling from textures. Obviously, as you can see in the preview, this is not something you want to use if you are working with textures that have patterns. So if you're working with bricks, or if you're working with a floor, with a tiling floor, you don't want to use this. You want to use this kind of OSL node. You want to use this when you're working, for example, with the ground textures, or if you're working with pebbles. You're working with something that already has enough randomness, but it's not tiling. It's using the textures and using the settings that you have here, you can introduce a lot of randomness, which allows you to having a texture that doesn't have any tiling, which is quite practical. Now, it may look that you need to load one OSL bitmap random tiling for your base color, for your roughness, for your normal map, but that's not the case. And the reason why, for example, the OSL bitmap lookup is so good and so important is because you can connect the UVs or whatever the settings you're doing here, you can connect these and you can apply to all the three textures. So for example, if I connect my UV and you connect to the UV coordinates, you can see again with just one single node, you can control all the textures. So again, that's why, for example, the OSL bitmap lookup, it does look simple, but it's actually quite practical and very flexible. I think this is now starting to take shape and showing why the OSL workflow is so powerful and so flexible. Now, another thing I want just to cover before we finish is the different options that you have here when you are outputting information from the OSL nodes. Obviously, you want to use the color when you're working with color, the RGB, but then you also have the opportunity to work with the red, green, blue, and alpha channel, and you have the luminance and average if you want to use. Why do you have these options here? Well, again, flexibility. As an example, if you are in a rush and you don't have, for example, a roughness map, you may want to click on the red channel, for example, and connect to your particular roughness. As you can see, the red, green, blue, they're all grayscale. And although I don't recommend you to do this, there are situations where perhaps you don't have the time to create a roughness map, and this could be a shortcut to get that. But I have another example that shows the power of having these nodes available. And the example that I have here, it's a texture that you can export when you create terrains in Houdini. So I use Houdini to create terrains, and along with the terrain, with the geometry, I can also export a couple of masks to create the material. So as an example, I can export a mask for my debris, for my height, for my rivers, for example. Instead of me exporting 4, 5, 6 maps, I can assign the maps to an EXR file, and the EXR, the red, green, blue, and alpha channel will have a map. And I can show you that very easily by connecting the masks to the preview. So for example, if I go to my red, and if I connect to the base column, you can see I have a map here. And then if I go to my green, I think this will be quite obvious what it is. You can see a couple of veins here. This is the mask for the rivers, for the streams. And then I have the blue, which I believe is my height mask as well. So it's really practical, the fact that instead of me having 4 textures or 3 textures, I have just a single one that has all the information that I need. And this also introduces flexibility to your workflow. Because if you change the terrain and you need to update the material, you don't need to reload 3 new textures. All you have to do is just reload 1 new texture and everything will be updated. So that's why having this information here available is so powerful and useful. And I think this is basically the introduction to the OSL bitmap. Just as a quick recap, remember, if you are working with materials, it's quite practical and useful for you to work with the OSL bitmap lookup. The reason why? Well, because you can connect multiple nodes to the UV coordinate, file name, other things, which introduce a lot of flexibility when you're creating materials. But if you just need one texture for a specific reason and you don't want to have all the nodes connected, then obviously the Uber bitmap is the best option for you because it has all the information that you need in just one go. Okay, so that's it for bitmaps into Studio Max using OSL nodes. Hopefully, I think in this video help you to understand a little bit how working with OSL, working with nodes really brings efficiency and brings you flexibility to your workflow. The next couple of videos, I'm going to cover the use of OSL nodes when you're creating materials. And hopefully, what I'll try to do and I'll try to cover is the most useful nodes that you're going to need when you're doing look development, meaning when you're doing your materials, when you're doing your lighting, and how you can replace your workflow with OSL nodes. So if you have anything specific that you'd like to know or you'd like to be covered, let me know in the comments, and I'll introduce that and include that in my next video. So thank you so much for watching and take care.